Hello everyone and welcome to this session of programming with Python. In this session we will see what are the various operations that can be performed on the Python string. So let's look at the objectives of our session. We will start by understanding what do we mean by indexing in Python. Afterward we will see how can we access the indelible element of the Python. Afterward we will see how can we perform the slicing operation on our string. And afterward we will see how to perform string concatenation and string replication. Now we will see how can we access the indelible character of a Python string. To understand that, we have to first understand how does Python store any string in the memory. A string is stored as an array in the block of memory, and an array is basically a holding structure in which the indelible holding cell are consecutive in nature. So Python string is stored as an array in the memory, and the first character of the string is stored at the 0th position, and the last character of the string is stored at the position which is 1 less than the total length of the string. So for example, here we have a string hello. Hello is made up of 5 different characters, namely H, E, L, 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 O. Now the first character of the string, that is hello, will be indexed at the 0th position. And the last character of the string, that is O, will be indexed at the position which would be 1 less than the total length of a string. In this case, O will be indexed at the 4th position while the length of our string hello is 5. Now if we want to access the indelible element of the string at a particular index, then for that purpose we use the bracket notation. The syntax of bracket notation is that we first write the name of the string or the name of variable of whom we want to access the element. We can also use the name of the variable in which our string is stored, followed by big brackets, and within the big bracket we write the index position. For example, let's say we have a variable named A which is storing a string hello. Now if we want to know what is stored at the index 0, we will write the name of the variable A followed by big brackets, and within the big brackets we will write the index number. For example, if we want to find out what element is stored at the 0th position, we will write A in the brackets and in the bracket index number, that is 0, and we will get H as an output. Similarly, if we want to find out what is located at the index 2nd, then we will write A and in the bracket 2, and we will get L as an output. Now strings are immutable in nature. That means once they are assigned to some variable, then the individual element of a string cannot be manipulated or changed. For example, here we have a string that is stored in a variable myString. Now as we assign the value to myString, we realize that the correct string is not land but band. So if we can change the first character of our string land, then we can correct our string. But Python doesn't allow us to do that. So if I would say that make the first character of the string B from L, then Python will give me an error that strings are immutable in nature and cannot be changed once they are assigned. Now we know that how can we access the individual character of the string in Python. Python also allows us to access the range of the character. We use the bracket notation also for accessing the range of character, and this is known as string slicing. So we first write the name of the variable, and in the bracket notation we write the starting index followed by colon operator and in the ending index. One thing to be note about string slicing is that the element at the ending index will not be included in the output. So for example, here we are string slicing over string hello. We want to find out what is stored from 0th position to the 2nd position. And when we will use our bracket notation and the colon operator, we will get HE as an output instead of HEL. So the element stored at the index 2nd, that is L, will not be included in the output. Only the element will be included just before the ending index. As we defined earlier that strings are basically used to represent a text value in Python, and when anything is included within quotation mark will be considered as a string, no matter it is a numerical value or any special character. Now there are some kind of operation that can be performed on a string. Suppose we want to add true string, namely John and Dalton, which are stored in variable A and B respectively. Now we can join these two strings by using string concatenation or addition. So we will use the string concatenation operator, which is same as the addition operator in mathematics, and we will combine the two string. Similarly, we can also perform the string replication. If we want to repeat any string multiple number of times, we will multiply the string with a number. For example, if we want to repeat our string hello 3 times, we will multiply our string with 3 and we will get our string as multiple or multiplied by 3 times. Now, one thing to note about string concatenation is while performing the string concatenation, only two string can be concatenated. If the data type of any one of the string is not as the same the other, then the string concatenation will give us an error. For example, here we have a variable named a which is storing a string value John, and another variable v which is storing a numerical value. And now if we want to perform the string concatenation, then Python will give us an error because Python don't know how to perform addition operation on integer and string type of value. So let's look at the summary of our session. We saw array is a sequence of character representing a text value. Anything enclosed within quotation mark is interpreted as a string in Python. Two string can be joined using a string concatenation operator. Individual character can be accessed using index, and string are immutable in nature. So that's all for this session. We will meet again in the next session discussing what are the various methods that can be performed on the string. Thanks for listening.